Welcome to the instructional video for the clinical coaching sessions for second year medical students. The clinical coaching sessions were started in the 2015-16 academic year in Doctoring 2 with the support and participation of the course IORs. These sessions were created by members of the UC Davis Academy of Master Clinical Educators. The goal of these sessions is to increase clinical coaching in the preclinical years, provide a bridge to third year clerkships, improve students' clinical reasoning skills, and to have fun. In the next few minutes, we'll learn about what to expect. Let us turn to Dr. Aronowitz, who will walk us through the video.
In the clinical coaching sessions, you are given the standardized patient's chief complaint and vital signs on a door note outside the exam room. You then have 20 minutes to take a focused history and complete the physical exam as a clinical coach observes you from the corner of the room. Next, you will step out for 15 minutes to formulate an oral presentation that includes your assessment, likely diagnosis, and plan. And during this interim, you may be shown additional lab or radiographic data that will help you formulate your plan. The oral presentation will be done at the patient's bedside to the coach. You will then receive 10 minutes of feedback from your coach about your history taking, your physical exam, your presentation, and your clinical reasoning in terms of arriving at a most likely diagnosis. The coach is typically a Doctoring 4 facilitator, a family medicine resident or faculty, or an internal medicine resident or faculty. The key thing to know about these encounters is the idea here is not that you've messed up if you get the diagnosis wrong, but it's to go through the process of getting a history, doing an exam, getting to practice an oral presentation, and getting to practice your clinical reasoning. The object is to work on your process of coming up with the diagnosis. So let's take a look at an example so you can see what happens in real time. So as you read the door notes before you enter the patient's room, it's best to think about things that might be already popping into your head for differential diagnoses just based on the door note. For example, if the patient's presenting with abdominal pain, begin generating your rough differential diagnosis such as peptic ulcer disease, acute appendicitis, cholecystitis, ectopic pregnancy, pelvic inflammatory disease, and so forth, so that you don't go into the room totally green and that you've thought about a few things before entering.
Student doctor, your time has begun. You may enter the room when ready.
Come in.
Hi, Miss James?
Yes, hi.
Hi, my name is Mark Jane. I'm a medical student, and I'll be taking care of you today.
Nice to meet you.
Likewise. Would you prefer me to call you Miss James, Janet, or something else?
Miss James.
Okay. Miss James, how are you feeling today?
Feeling better. My stomach's been bothering me.
I'm so sorry to hear that's been going on. Tell me a little more about your pain.
It's been getting painful, I don't know. Probably about a month.
Uh-huh.
I notice it after I eat, after about an hour after I eat.
Okay. And where does it hurt the most?
It's kind of just right in here, right in the center.
Okay.
You should use approximately 5 to 10 minutes to take a focused history using open-ended questions, followed by more targeted questions in order to help you focus in on things. You'll have access to writing instruments during the session, but make sure that you provide adequate eye contact and make a point of conveying empathy for the patient's discomfort, as well as using verbal and nonverbal cues that you've learned about in Doctoring 1. For the past medical history, you don't have to get a super detailed history because this is a time-limited encounter, but you will certainly want to capture the gist of the past medical history as it could be relevant to the history of present illness.
All right, Ms. James. I think I have enough information about what's been going on. I'm so sorry that you haven't been feeling well. Next, I would like to move on to the physical exam portion of this visit so I can help zero in on the cause of your abdominal pain.
Okay, sounds good.
You should wash your hands before starting the physical exam. A head-to-toe exam is usually not practical given the time constraints. This is, after all, a time-limited patient encounter and a reality of practicing medicine. It's important, as you become a physician, to gain a sense of what is relevant to examine depending upon the patient's history. For example, in the case of abdominal pain, you'll probably want to examine the lungs and the heart, since some diseases in these organ systems can cause abdominal pain. For example, right lower lobe pneumonia can cause right upper quadrant pain, or an atypical myocardial infarction can present with epigastric abdominal pain. But you get the idea. Keep things a little bit broader so that you examine the organ systems that may pertain to the one you're focused on. You should also ask for permission during the physical exam and attend to the patient's comfort. Remember to pull out the leg rest when you ask the patient to recline on the exam table, and also use appropriate draping technique. Some scenarios may necessitate sensitive maneuvers such as pelvic, rectal, or genitourinary exams. In these cases, specifically ask for permission to conduct the maneuver during the physical exam portion of the encounter. The patient will then indicate to you the location where the result is stored, for example, in a drawer in the exam room.
All right, Ms. James, for the next portion of the exam, we'd like to perform a pelvic and rectal exam.
Sure, the results are in the two top drawers behind you.
Sure, thank you. All right, Ms. James, thank you so much for coming in today. I think I have enough information about what's been going on. So what I'll do next is step out of the room for a few minutes to discuss the case with my preceptor, and I'll be back to present to my coach.
Okay?
I'll be back in about 15 minutes.
The time for this encounter has ended. Student doctor, please exit to the hallway where you will have 15 minutes to prepare your 5-minute oral presentation, followed by 10 minutes of feedback.
Once you've completed the initial encounter where you've obtained your history and physical, you will be asked to leave the room. At that juncture, you'll have 15 minutes to review some labs as well as some radiographic data. If you feel like your skills at reading x-rays are not quite honed to excellence yet in this early point in your career, there's actually a radiologist's official read affixed to the radiographic data. You'll then prepare an oral presentation that includes your history, physical exam, pertinent lab and radiographic data, as well as your assessment and plan. You'll re-enter the room and you will deliver this oral presentation to your coach in front of the standardized patient. Again, the goal here is not for you to get the correct diagnosis. It's to go through the process of getting a history, doing an exam, reviewing a little bit of lab and radiographic data, and then getting to do an oral presentation that includes your assessment and plan. Once you've completed your oral presentation, the clinical coach will spend about 10 minutes giving you feedback about your history taking, physical exam, oral presentation, and clinical reasoning.